we've showed now is instead of that 40% response rate, we're at 85% with the combination of Bexmarilimab with standard of care HMAs. And then also not just the response, but complete remission.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Faron Pharmaceuticals CEO, Dr. Juho Jalkanen. Juho, very good to speak with you. The latest Bexmab results you presented at the ESMO Congress in Barcelona showed really strong response and remission rates in high-risk MDS. How do these compare with what's currently available for patients?
Well, this is absolutely game-changing for what is currently available for patients. So the standard of care treatment is a hypomethylating agent, which is a form of chemo. They've been around for 20 years. After that, there is nothing. And the problem with the current standard of care is that only around 40% respond to that. And then usually patients, unfortunately, relapse. And after that, there is nothing. And what we've showed now is instead of that 40% response rate, we're at 85% with the combination of Bexmarilimab with standard of care HMAs. And then also not just the response, but complete remission. So completely the cancer's gone and all blood counts have recovered. Even that rate is an astonishing 45%, which is one of the highest ever seen in this field. So truly game changing.
Now that you've got orphan drug status and clear guidance from the FDA on your registrational trial, what's the next step towards potential accelerated approval?
So, well, first and most importantly is getting that registrational trial going. And then what the FDA has explicitly said that there is accelerated approval possibility with a response rate readout. And this response rate readout, especially which I highlighted, is going to need complete remission. And that's where we're very strong on clearing out the cancer and normalizing blood counts. And this is very important for these patients, which are usually deeply anemic and deeply neutropenic. So if we hit that, there's a chance for accelerated approval pretty soon in the registrational trial. Ultimately, the registrational trial, as nowadays always, needs to show a survival benefit. But again, if you hit the hard CR endpoint, that will lead to a survival benefit.
The biomarker data linking Clever-1 engagement to patient response is fascinating. How could this help you target the patients most likely to benefit?
That's an excellent question. And that's, I would say, one of the best things or most important things that was recently presented at ESMO is that the problem in the field has been that these patients have been given pretty toxic, cancer-killing drugs like chemo or HMAs. And they can kill the cancer. They're good in that. But now through our biomarker data and what's known in the field, that when the disease mainly resides in the bone marrow, those toxic agents seldom or poorly kill the cancer when it's deep in the bone marrow, and that's where the core of the disease is. We do exceptionally well when it's there. We penetrate the bone marrow. When we have good target engagement in the bone marrow, that leads to these very strong responses. So this highlights Bex as a truly disease-modifying agent, not just a classical toxic cancer drug, but a truly disease-modifying agent drilling into the core of the disease and making it better.
You ended the first half with a solid cash position, 13.5 million euros, and also good momentum. How well funded are you for the next phase, and what are the key milestones investors should be watching out for?
So we're well funded into next year, but getting that registrational trial started will require funds. And we're now actively working on multiple streams on how to get it done. So next steps, what people will need to look out for is business transactions. And this is For example, partnering is one of our main streams. Also, fundraising opportunity. There's multiple ways of funding this upcoming registrational trial, and we're super active on all of these fronts. And happy to say, soon we'll come out on what materializes.
Yeah, I hope you'll keep us updated on progress with that. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
And you, Dr. Juho Jalkanen, CEO of Faron Pharmaceuticals.